Stop it testing.
Yeah, see, we stop here into installation part. Okay, so now it is this is the checkpoint client. Okay, this one.
Okay,
if I see VPN option, this is the check endpoint security, right? Checkpoint. And also if I open here, no site is configured. Would you like to configure a new site? So yes, I want to configure. Okay, when you just click on there, you get this window first time. Okay.
Okay.
So next here, please wait while trying to detect the site automatically. Okay. It is detecting automatically sites. Okay. So here we give the server IP address. Okay. Which is 192.168.0.250. Right.
Yeah.
And also I'll put this PC into my outside network. Okay. I'll bridge this one because I want this PC into the internet, right? Not into any other networks. Okay. Here we give the display name. Okay. So I'll give checkpoint head office remote access VPN. Okay. Let me do the next here. And at the same time, ncpa.cpl, because the thing is I need to change the IP address, okay, from DHCP, because right now the IP address of this PC is in the 10.4.4 range. Okay.
Yeah.
So let me change these things here. See this one. So I just give the DHCP. I'll get the IP address from DHCP server.
From the DHCP.
And please wait while creating the new site. Okay, so it is creating the time. This may take several minutes. Site creation failed to create the new site region. Site is not responding. Okay. So let me do one thing here. Let me open my command prompt cmd here. IP config. I get the IP address. Okay. If I try to ping my firewall 192.168.0.250, I will to ping. Okay. Now I'll just back here and next. It is checking. It have the reachability till that site or not.
Through VPN connection, it will checking.
No. It is just now. It
normal
is create thing. Now. It just create. Yeah, it's just ping to that IPA. It is available or not?
Okay.
See, the security certificate. We are getting this error, right? The certificate warning. Okay. So I'll just trust and continue. See, username and password. Okay.
Okay.
So I just next here. Site created successfully. Okay. I'll finish. Do you want to connect? Yes, I want. Yeah. Okay. So if I use this one, we have this username, right? Bob. And I use the password for that is admin, right? And connect.
Yeah.
Detecting proxy configuration, connecting to site. Okay. Connection succeeded. Okay.
Yeah.
So if I ping my internal server, which is this one, right?
10.1.1.
Request timeout. Request timeout. Okay, so let me check first IP config now. Okay, see, we have this adapter, this one Ethernet adapter connection, this one, this new adapter, this is due to this checkpoint client, okay, virtual adapter, okay. This is the IP address 172.16.10.1, okay. This is the subnet mask 255.255.255.0, okay. I also run this route print command here. So 10.1.1.250 reachable via this, okay. And this one also reachable via this. This network also reachable via this, okay. Did you see 10.1.1.0 network is reachable via this? Not here, right? That's why it is not ping. If I try to ping my network, which is 10.1.1.255.250, it may ping or may not.
I think this concept and here when the Cisco concept route is coming, now static route is coming.
Yes, yes. So that thing now I configure, okay? Okay, let me now go to into my smart dashboard here, okay? I'm here also, I can also define here my destination network, okay? In policy, we can also leave it any, but I am just defining my inside network, okay? I just give inside here. So inside HU network, okay? And also I am now going to my head office firewall, okay? I'm just editing this firewall. To network management, we have a VPN domain, okay?
Okay.
See, right now we have here manually defined empty VPN, DM VPN group, okay?
Okay.
But see, set domain for remote access community, okay? So I am clicking this one. For remote access community traffic, set an alternative VPN domain for this gateway, okay? Right now what happened, they are using same, this one, this gateway only.
DM VPN thing.
Yeah. So I just select this community here and set. Here I call my network, which is my inside network, right? 10.1.1.0 network, okay? Or we have this inside HO, this one, okay? Both are the same, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And let me also check here into my VPN client. Everything is fine here. Here we have, see, we define this username and password method, okay, for authentication. That's why we selected the username and password when we create that site, okay?
Okay.
By default, allow office mode to all users, okay? And see, this pool, checkpoint default office pool.
Okay,
if I check this one, okay, I'll show you this pool. This detail of this pool, okay? This pool have the IP address which is assigned to our VPN client, okay?
VPN client host.
Yeah. That virtual IP, virtual adapter get the IP from this pool only, okay?
Okay. How can you set this pool here?
No, it's by default come, okay?
Okay. If I mandatory give it to the IP address, how can I set the mandatory IPs?
Yeah, you just select, you just create your new pool and call that pool into that place, okay?
Okay.
Let me install the policy now. One more time. So policy installation. Tomorrow I'll teach you these things, these HTTPS inspection and user identification and application URL in RAT.net. Okay. After that we have one or two classes more. So in one class I'll explain you packet flow. Okay. Packet flow take around 30 minutes only. Okay. And also remaining things.
Okay.
I'll check it. What also you need to know. So I'll teach you. Yeah. I'm just selecting my standard policy here. Install the policy. Policy installation is started now. Okay, here we see the status VPN is connected, right?
Okay.
Here remote CP, HO, RA, VPN, this is the, here we see the packets in which is encrypted and decrypted. Okay?
Encrypted and decrypted, yeah.
Okay, I'll show you all these stuffs now. Let the policy installation.
Here is also same running ASA concept.
Yeah, same. Basically the checkpoint and ASA basically both release the same thing. Because the
first release the concepts.
Checkpoint. I am not sure who released the concept.
Okay.
I think checkpoint released the concept because Cisco just started just next generation things, right? These guys have lots of business on next gen things. Okay. So let me connect again here, okay? So I'll give the name admin connect detecting proxy configuration. Okay. See here we can also if I we see the details here. He give the little bit information. Okay. Connection is succeeded. Okay.
Okay.
So let me close this one. Now let me also check the IP address first. Not this one. We give this one this IP address 172.16.10.1. Okay.
Okay.
Let me go to network offset. Networks. This is CP default office mode, right? This one. This have 172.16.10.0. Okay. So the starting.
You put it by default.
Yeah. So 172.16.10.1. This thing comes by default from the checkpoint. Okay.
Okay.
It's not. We can also change. We can create our own pool and we can assign this.
Yeah.
Call this pool into that. They are into that place. That. Office mode place, okay, into our security gateway, VPN client, office mode here. We have ability, we can change, okay, any
problem. Okay.
I am using the default one only. So now, this is the IP address, okay, if I also run the route print command here. Now see 10.1.1.0 network, which is reachable via this thing. Okay. So we get this network because we add this thing, this network into our VPN domain, right? For remote access community. So that's why we are getting this network here. Okay. If I ping it to my 10.1.1.221, which is my inside server, so I am able to ping. Okay. If I also do the trace route here,
it will be go through your VPN.
Yeah. See, this is my firewall, right? Now this server, okay? So this is going to, here we also, here see, encrypted and decrypted packet is increases, right?
Yeah.
If I open my browser here, HTTP 10.1.1.221. HTTP 10.1.1.221. Okay. I run HTTPS 10.1.1.251. This is my inside. This one is management server. Okay. I am also able to access this one. I am also able to access my web server. Okay.
Okay.
All these things going through the that client only, that tunnel only. See, the encrypted and decrypted package increased here. Okay.
Okay.
So that is the way we can basically communicate with this thing. Okay. Now let me also do one thing. Let me take, see, we also have the mobile client for that. Okay. That thing. We install one app into our mobile. So I already installed this app into my mobile. So let me connect with this with my phone. That is, this number is this 580913424. Okay. So this is my, I am taking the NDX on my mobile phone. Start now. Accept. Okay, so I'll get that Anydex of my phone. Okay. So let me open the checkpoint VPN, which is the VPN capsule. Okay. You can find this one. So if I create a new site here, I'll give the name CPRA VPN. Okay. And I will give the server IP address 192.168.1.0.250. Okay. So it is start creating. Okay.
Which application you installed in a mobile?
VPN capsule. Checkpoint. You just search for checkpoint VPN client. Okay.
Okay.
So, do you trust this site? Okay. So I will trust. Okay. So I want username and password for that. Okay. So if I see, as soon as I put my user credential here, so I'll disconnect it. Okay. I got disconnected. Admin. Because now it starts using this VPN client. Okay. So it basically disconnected my Anydex, I think. And disconnect this guy also. Disconnecting now. Fail to connect connection to site. Timeout. Okay. Not an issue. Okay, let me again put the login credential here, Bob and admin, this password, connect again. is little bit slow. Failed to connect. Why it is failing? Wow. It must connect, okay. Otherwise, I need to check my if I enable this mobile or not. See, I am connecting, okay. It is connected. The thing is, I am disconnecting here. So let me do one thing. If I try again, I cannot to connect, okay, with this one. Let me close this now. Connection is rejected by the server. The remote user has rejected the connection. Actually, AnyDex is a third party, right? That's why it is not connecting. Start, accept. See, it is connected, right?
Yes. How did you connect it? One second, explain this one. Which applications are you installed in a PC?
Yeah,
and
see, see if I check the details here, it gives the details, everything there. Okay, connected. This is the IP address. He is getting 172.16.10.2. Okay, IPsec and UDP, 3-dash and okay. size algorithm. Okay, lots of things are there. Okay,
okay.
I'll share that application, not an issue.
Okay,
so that application, if I disconnect this one, yes, and let this is the this VPN capsule.
What is the name?
This VPN capsule.
Okay, VPN capsule.
Yeah. That is the
for checkpoint. And this is for
checkpoint VPN capsule. Okay.
Okay.
That is the app. Okay, man.
Okay.
So let me now disconnect this thing. So that is the way if we have an app in mobile, we can also connect with this gateway and we access the internal resources. The same thing by
this is called remote VPN.
Yeah, the same thing basically these Amazon and Flipkart guys doing right now. They connect with the company resources via VPN internal only. They are using the same thing. Okay.
Okay.
Let me also verify. See, right now we are logging via Bob, which is our local user, right? So let me now try with my AD users. Okay. So if I go to here into users, LDAP groups and VPN AD users. Okay. CN equal to user, okay. So user group, these are the VPN users. Right now this is the username, okay. So let me add one user group, okay. This is the RA users, okay, remote access user.
Okay.
I'll add my VPN AD, VPN users, okay. And also Bob and also admin, okay. We added these users detail here, okay. RA users. Okay. Now I'm going to my global policies here in VPN encryption profile in advance. Yeah, everything is fine here. We have this remote access, okay. So if I in remote use default value, okay, everything is default. Okay, that's fine. VPN authentication, yeah, encryption, okay, it is also fine. VPN advanced tab, route. See, hub mode for secure client AZ. We generally select this one, okay?
Okay.
Route all traffic when connected, okay? Office mode. Use first allocated office mode IP address for all connection to the gateway of the site. I'll also select this one, okay? I leave it these things without unselected here. In certificate, nothing we can need to do. Yeah, these things is fine also. Okay, now let me. Okay, let me also go into advanced settings, I think. Load properties in advanced we have. VPN add. See, here we also have these things, okay? IPsec, like settings, UDP, encapsulation by GDM, okay? Lots of things are there. VPN advanced property, VPN IC properties, okay? Enable IC handling and all these stuff, link selection, remote access VPN, okay? Support transport mode and all these stuff, tunnel management, okay?
Okay.
Certificate we gave, portal settings, TLS 1.2, TLS 1, we can change these things, okay? Also, no identity awareness, okay. So these are the advanced settings, okay? Generally, we can't change these advanced
settings too.
Yeah.
Okay.
As I am just telling you, if someone asks, like if there is a deployment, if they have these type of needs, then if you just only have to know, there is also, we can also have these options there, okay?
Okay.
So in VPN client, apply this one in office mode. See, allow office mode to all users, okay? I am just offering offer office mode to a group. RA users, okay? I am selecting this group here and also remote access here we have everything fine. This is the SSL VPN things, okay? I'll tell you later what are these things today only. So let me, okay, now I'm going to my remote access community here, okay? In here we have a gateway information, here we have a user information, right? So let me delete this. I'll add this one, RA users, okay?
RA users.
Let me install the policy. This AD sometimes bugs, sometimes doesn't work, okay? Because previously AD works, but that thing is not working. When I did the lab, okay. After that, this local start working. But if I connect with my mobile, then AD works, okay.
Okay.
So these are the issue with these VMs only, okay. In real device, there is no such type of thing. Okay. Actually, I am getting one call, so I put you in mute for some time only, okay. Only one. Okay. So the policy installation is succeeded, okay. So let me go to my client PC here, okay. Let me first connect with my local user, which is Bob. I put the password here, admin, just connect. If see also, if we want to add these VPN network, these DMZ network also there, then we just add them into that thing, into VPN domain only, okay?
Okay.
We want to provide the DMZ access to them also. So see, it is succeeded. So I'm disconnecting. Now I'll connect again with my AD user HR1, okay? And admin at the 123. it is connected. No, I didn't waste my time doing the troubleshooting of this thing. Okay, because okay. It works sometimes, it doesn't work. So it's not a like. See, it negotiation with okay. site is failed. Okay, so leave it for leave it this one. Okay.
Okay.
Now we will start this mobile access. Okay.
Okay.
So basically, what happened in mobile access? We only need to enable this mobile access plate first, this one, okay?
Okay.
Only this plate we need to enable. And after that, what happened? If I am going to my firewall, yeah? Here we have mobile access tab, okay? So here we get some default settings, okay? These are the SSL, VPN, web browser, okay? These things here, mobile device, iOS, and see capsule VPN connect. I'm using this capsule VPN, right? For connecting my mobile device, right? Now only. Authentication, we are using username, password. Office mode, yeah, I want to use office mode for our register. See, it basically replicated from there to there also, okay? And this is portal customization. If we want to do use mobile access logo, if we have logo and all this stuff, this is for portal settings. Okay, so I am just changing my this IP address here. Okay,
okay,
this one 192.168.0.250. Okay, this is my main URL now, and SSL client also automatically decide on client according to the endpoint machine capabilities. Okay, HTTP okay. proxy, name resolution. Here we can define the DNS server also. Okay, so it get the information from here. We have a bin server, then we can give the bin server information here. Okay,
okay,
link path translation, URL translation. We have lots of options there. Okay, so these only depends on the customer requirement. Okay,
okay.
In here also we have the support. This allow VPN client to route the traffic through gateway. Okay, so generally the thing is generally people not prefer these RA VPNs. Okay, if they have, then they only want this type of VPNs for only few users. Okay,
okay,
not for everyone. So I am just selecting this one. See, we also have this tab, mobile access. Okay.
Mobile access.
So I am going to mobile access, open mobile access policy into smart dashboard. Okay. Here we get the information. Okay. Actual information, actual policy, how we can define the policies for mobile access. Okay, so this is the mobile access tab here. Okay, here we have an overview. Let the overview come. Okay, here we give one security gateway is allowing mobile access, right? Which is CPHO firewall. This is the web application, web app 10.1.1.221, which I defined when I enable the mobile access blade, right? Web app. Okay. So basically this mobile access support web applications, mobile application, mail applications, file applications, Citrix applications and native applications. Okay.
Okay.
We have this policy here. So in policy, basically we are defining HR users. Okay. Which is from Hemin.net, web app 10.1.221 and word clock. Okay.
Okay.
Install on this firewall. So let me also include here some more users. Internal users group. Okay. RA users. Okay. It include all users. Okay.
Okay.
This is the gateway information. This is our gateway. Okay. So we can add and view all these things. Okay, there also. Here we have applications. Okay, application tab. So we have a web application here. If we also have another file application, we can add this application here, okay, by clicking to new. Citrix, if we have a Citrix server, we can install you. We can also call this. If we have a webmail here, we define the webmail details, okay?
Okay.
Like that, if we have a mobile mail, then we define this thing in authentication. We have username and password, certificate authentication also, personal certificate also, okay? Client certificate. Okay, so here we have a client certificate. If we want to, we can create that new certificate, okay? According to these things basically depend on the upper our requirement, okay?
Okay.
Now we have a portal setting also. In portal setting, portal customization, okay? So here we can customize the portal. Alternative portal, if we have alternative portal, then we give the URL here, okay?
Okay.
Endpoint security on demand. These are for endpoint security solutions only. Okay. Capsule workstation settings, additional settings. Okay. We have these information like that only. Here we have VPN client, link translation, single sign-on login session. Lots of things are there. Okay. So generally we put the default only. Okay. Yeah. We want to see the AD users, then we just go to into this and click here. We get the users details now. Okay. Now here we get the all the users details. Okay.
Object list.
Yeah, see, we are getting these information here also. Okay. This thing depends on our requirement. So we done with the mobile access configuration. Let me save the configuration. So I just press Control S. Okay. As I press the Control S, so it automatically save completely successful. Okay. Now I just close this one, and I go to my policy tab here, and I just install this policy. Okay.
So you didn't create here anything for remote VPN?
No, it's automatically created. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
We need to create for mobile access.
Yeah. When we do these things for that client to site VPN, these things basically replicated to mobile access also. Okay.
Okay.
So we don't need to do anything. These are the logs. See, today this 172.16.10 destination is this one. Okay. Username is Bob. Try to ping. If we see this this one on here also, this one, this is decrypt sign. Okay.
Decrypted.
So we see like that only. Let me go into login here. I think I get lots of log. So success policy is configuration is succeeded now. Okay. So let me open my browser here. https://192.168.0.250/SSL VPN. Okay. We just write this whole URL into our URL tab and just enter. See, I am getting this warning because I am using the self-signed certificate, right?
Yeah.
See, I am getting this checkpoint mobile. Okay. So I am using as a local user first, Bob. I'll put my password here. Okay. So now I am get the access. See, I have this web server. Okay. If I click onto this, so I get this web access of this web server. Okay. Let me come back from here. If I try to type here into this one, https://10.1.1.251. Yeah, access denied, the destination of requested, not been configured. Okay. So basically, the okay. thing is which we configured there, only these things are we are able to access only. Okay.
Okay.
Via this portal only. Okay. So this is the SS, this is the basically thin client VPN. Okay. In case of we are talking about checkpoint ASA. Okay. Similar to thick client VPN. Okay.
Okay. Thin or thick?
No, yeah, thin, not thick. Take any connect, thin client. Okay. See, we also have word clock application by default. So, I am going to see here. We see all the word clocks. Okay.
Okay.
So let me sign out. Sign out. Sign in again. Let me log in with my AD users here.
AD user.
I am able to get the access, right? HR1. Okay. Mm. I am also able to access this web server. Okay. Mm. And I am also able to access this word clock. Okay. So see here I am here, my HR users and Bob both working, right? Local and remote. So let me again take the index of my phone. Okay. So this is my, where is my index? Let me open index here. Let me connect. Start now, asset. Okay. So now I open my VPN capsule again. Okay. Now I'm logging as a HR user here. I'll put the password. Press the connect button. Failed to connect.
For user authentication.
HR1. Connect to failed. Okay. If I try with Bob, so that is the that is the only problem with these things only. This VMs only. Okay.
Okay.
Our configuration is right because we are both things working with mobile access, right? But why it does not work with that thing? We basically we call the same thing only there. See, right now I connect with Bob. So let me disconnect again. Let me connect with HR1. That's why I'm confused why it is not working with HR today. Actually, I invested my whole day doing this thing.
Okay.
That's why I don't want to waste any time now. It is failing. Okay. So not an issue. Basically, that is the way we do this SSL VPN and the mobile access VPN, all these stuffs into our gateway. Okay. So let me sign out from here. Remove. I'll connect here as a, let me type with HR1 again. It is working. Let me enter 123. See, connecting to site. See, negotiation with site failed. Okay. So let me log in with Bob now. With Bob, it is working. Okay. It's not a big deal, man. See, this thing with that due to these BMs and all these stuff. Maybe there are compatibility issues between them. I didn't try this thing in R80.10 with the same security management and same gateway. Okay.
Okay.
And I think R80.10. Not access VPN. We have a very big guide for that.
Yeah.
In Cisco also, we have lots of things in remote access VPN. Okay. These hybrid mode, easy mode. I forget that name. Plus mode also there.
NME plus and NME client mode. Three modes are there.
Yeah, lots of modes are there. Yeah, three modes are there basically. But lots of things are there. Okay. That is we have like that. So if we have a requirement then. So only the thing is IPsec VPN remote access. I'll explain these things. This thing I also explain. Capsule and policy, okay. Office mode I explain to you. Desktop security. Secure confusion verification. See, I didn't explain you the desktop policies. Okay, I think that required license. Okay, so that thing is not there. Advanced configuration. Secondary connect SSL extender. We don't have this. VPN client. What about the commands? Commands, we have nothing. Okay, now the remaining thing is I'll tell you a little bit about digital mode. Okay.
Okay.
Because I don't have scenario like this, so I can show you the practical on digital mode. But I show you where we have this digital mode. In remote access, see, we have a support digital mode. Okay. It is by default supported now in R80.10. Okay. So what is the meaning of this? See, you visit any customer site there. Okay. So generally what they have, they basically give you the access of HTTP and HTTPS website, right?
Okay.
So what happened, and you want to access your corporate network resources from that customer location. So that time basically you use this visitor mode, okay?
Okay.
For that. So you connect by using visitor mode with your resources. So it basically decrypted, it basically encapsulated all the traffic into HTTPS tunnel, okay? That is the visitor mode, nothing else, nothing more than this. So actually I don't have like that scenario. If I have any one firewall, then I put my one PC there, then I connect with this one. It takes lots of time. Okay. That's why it is enough for you in remote access VPN, I think so.
Okay.
Okay. So